been explaining some way to blow over 5-1 motion, and those phrases might be a little too much for some viewers. Today, I will show you how to practice with randomness. In other words, how to develop system in your head to improvise. Let me explain the idea of tree diagram. Let me draw a tree now. Trunk, branch, branches, and leaves, tree, and graph based on the idea of the shape of a tree from point to some point, and those possibility or relationships are drawn with the lines. This is a graph, and it's tree. Tree diagram. And to deal with randomness of the possibility when you connect the phrases, we'll apply primitive idea of tree diagram to improvise some jazz. Let's get the line part of phrase on G7 and two different lines on C major 7, line 1, line 2. Then you may want to practice is line 1, line 2, once each in rotation. But I would recommend you to practice these randomly. Like from one phrase on G7, line 1, line 2, line 2, line 1, line 2, line 1, line 1, line 2. Without thinking about it. You can add another one, so you have three lines on tonic major, and I would say the same thing. You should practice these randomly. The most important part of this practice is that you don't think which line you will play. And before you'd add another line on tonic major, it's good to add the other line on G7. And you can make two tree diagrams. You can keep one line on tonic major, and you practice two different lines on 5-7. So it's kind of reversed tree diagram. After a while of practice, you might be very comfortable to do those things. Then you can practice two different lines on G7 and two different lines on C7, and just practice those combinations randomly. The examples of first demonstration today, they are connected on the first beat of the tonic major, and the note was E, which is a third. And also, you should practice those lines connected on the first beat of the C major as G, which is fifth, or ninth, D. Now that you have groups of phrases based on which note comes on the first beat of tonic major, and you mix all the phrases and practice them randomly. Through this practice, you won't be tied up with licks and idiomatic phrases that you may copy from solos of other people. But importantly, this is just technical practice. And in modern context, jazz improvisation is about expressing yourself. In other words, expressing your feelings at the moment. So I would say this practice is just a preparation before you get together with other musicians to form a band to express yourself. All right, a saxophone can be a friend for life. Keep playing it.